Morning students, so now we will see the combination of capacitors. So in combination of capacitors, we will see the series combination and the parallel combination. So series combination is, so first we will start with the series combination. So you can see in the diagram or the figure, so C1 and C2, there are two capacitors where the left, that is the negative plate of the first capacitor C1 is connected to the positive plate of the capacitor C2. So this is the, these are the two capacitors. So first we will see the series combination for the two capacitors. Then we will go for the same thing we can, that we will say the same equation can be extended to n number of capacitors which are connected in series. So there is a term called equivalent capacitor. So equivalent capacitor is nothing but whose capacitance value will be equal to the capacitance of the n number of capacitors. That is, equivalent capacitor is a single capacitor whose value will be equal to the sum of the values of n number of capacitors. Okay, so in series capacitor, how it is connected? The negative plate of the first capacitor is connected to the positive plate of the second capacitor. And if there are n number of capacitor, the connection goes on, in extends in the same manner. So here you can see in the second figure, the we have seen for two plates now. The third plate will be, again, the negative plate will be connected to the positive plate of the third capacitor. Negative plate of the third capacitor is connected to the positive plate of the fourth capacitor. And this connection goes on increasing. So how many capacitors we are taking? We can just join it by in the same manner. Okay. Yes, let us go to the theory now. Combination of the capacitors, that is for series combination. So let C1 and C2 be the capacitors connected in series. The left of C1 and the right of C2 are connected to the two terminals of the battery, and they have the charges plus Q and minus Q. So plus Q is for the positive plate, minus Q is for the negative plate. So in series combination, one thing you have to remember is the charge remains same. The number of charges in each plate remains the same. So how many you are connecting in series, the charge remains same. The potential drops varies from one plate to other plate, or from one capacitor to other capacitor. So for example, now we will take for two capacitors, let V1 and V2 be the potential drops across the capacitors C1 and C2. So therefore, the net potential of the two capacitors is equal to V1 plus V2. Okay. So by equation of the capacitor, we have potential is equal to the ratio of charge by capacitor. So here we will take for V1, as I told you, charge remains same. So therefore, Q upon C1 plus Q upon C2. Okay. So this is considered as the equation number 1. Therefore, now we will take Q common here, because Q is same here for C1 and C2, taking Q common, and we will take Q in the denominator for V here. Okay, so that will be V by Q equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2, right? So this is considered as the equation number 2. Okay, now effective capacitance. So what is, I told you previously, what is meant by effective capacitance, where the sum of the capacitors of n number of capacitors in a series will be equal to that capacitance of the single capacitor. So that is known as the equivalent capacitor or effective capacitor. Okay, so that is equal to C equal to Q by V. Therefore, here comparing equation with 3 and 3 with 2, we get 1 upon C equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. Okay, so this is for 2 capacitors. So if there are n number of capacitors, now it will be equal to 1 by C equal to, that is effective capacitance is equal to sum of the capacitor ratio of the sum of the individual capacitors, that is 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3 plus 1 upon dash so on 1 upon Cn. So this is the effective capacitors for the series combination. Okay, I hope you have understood this. So let us go to the parallel combination. Okay, so you can see in the diagram for parallel capacitors, positive plate of the C1 is connected to positive plate of the C2. Similarly, negative plate is connected to the negative plate of C2, and the potential difference is same for both of this, for both the capacitors. Similarly, if there are n number of capacitors, you can join individually. So from this positive plate of C1 to positive plate of C2 and positive plate of C3 and so on till n number of capacitors. So here also negative to negative, negative to negative, and all are connected to a single main battery, and the potential drop will be equal for each of the capacitor. And here the charge. Okay, so we can see here from the figure, two capacitors are arranged in parallel. In this case, the potential difference will be same applied across both the capacitors. So as I told you, the potential difference or potential drop remains the same for n number of capacitors. So how many capacitors you are applying, it remains same only for the parallel combination. Okay, then so let us see Q1 equal to 1 upon C1V and Q2 equal to C2V. So consider this as equation number 1. Then equivalent capacitor is 1 with charge Q equal to. So now net charge on the capacitors will be sum of the capacitors, charge on the capacitors, that is Q equal to Q1 plus Q2. Now from the equation we have Q equal to C into V, so that is equal to C1V. So for individual capacitors we are taking C1V plus C2V. So this is equation 3. So from equation 3 we have C equal to C1 plus C2. Okay, so here we will take it as C equal to C1 plus C, because here V is taken common, so that is CV equal to V is taken common C1 plus C2. So V and V gets cancelled here. So we will get this equation, C is equal to C1 plus C2. Okay, so this is the capacitor for parallel combination for two capacitors. So if there are n number of capacitors, it will be the equivalent capacitor C is equal to sum of the individual capacitors. So sum of the n number of individual capacitors. Hope you have understood it. Thank you.